Hello, vengeful tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM The Long War with me, BlueAnkylo. In our last episode, we managed to get everybody some pulse weapons, we've gotten a couple mechs, we shot down a bunch of ships and stuff relatively recently, we're almost at the end of our first year, things are going interesting. Anyway, the main thing to do now, and I want to show this off just in case something cool happens, is to attack HQ. The Exalt HQ. We know it's not in the US, so we've actually managed to do it without guessing, because we've tried to go to the United States, it wasn't there, and seeing as they were already out of the project, the XCOM project, it didn't hurt us. So, we know it's Russia by process of elimination, basically, and this should do it. Unless I'm really misunderstanding how the game works. Analyzing intelligence data, and... I have to actually click the button.
That's it, Commander.
Alright, thanks. Alright, so we got ourselves a mission. This will be a 10-squad mission, kind of like the alien base assaults. And maybe I'll choose the soldiers with you this one time, because I so rarely do that anymore. So let's see. The way I pick it out is we're starting with Sandless. Now I'm going to pick out a scout, and an assault, and a rocketeer from the top highest ranking soldiers. We're going to want a couple mechs, although I will obviously want a medic. What else do we need? Maybe a sniper? Probably sniper. That leaves us four. In fact, I'll probably take one of each class, plus the two mechs. That seems the fairest. So what am I missing? Gunner, right? I'm missing a gunner and an engineer. So who we got for highest ranked gunners and engineers? We got Commander! Currently our highest ranked engineer, and... Did I say assault? No, I have an assault. Scout, infantry, medic, sniper, rockets probably, actually. No, we got rockets. Gunner, sorry, gunner. Short-term memory. It's difficult while you're commenting. Alright, we got every class, and then we'll take our two best mechs. Unfortunately, Hero Hex Archer is not our best mech, I'm sorry. Shogun's pretty good, though. Jaeger's pretty good. So we got... Let me just double-check what our Shogun has. Ranger, heat ammo, fire control, and collateral damage. See, collateral damage can be really useful for blowing up walls and stuff here to make our life easier. Seeing as Exalt are cover-based fighters, this might be useful. What are our other options? Jaeger and Pathfinder. The Pathfinder is very quick, but maybe not the right class for this one, because we're not really scouting too much. We won't be able to move forward much. Flush is good. You've got jet boost. Yeah, I think we'll take, actually, I thought I was going to take the Pathfinder, but I think we'll take the Shogun and the Jaeger. The Jaeger should do really good damage. Ranger still has flush, platform stability. We don't have, like, light them up yet. One day. Alright, and then for equipment, might as well free up everything. And this shouldn't take too long. We only got one Aegis armor. We really do need to improve that one of these days. But from now on, infantry get pulse rifles, and... I mean, the scope is just killer with the pulse rifle. In fact, even the laser sighting might be a good +5 crit. I mean... Sandless has some pretty amazing aim. 114, we could pump it up to 119 with the laser sight, and that would give him 15... You give him 35 base crit. That's pretty good. But I think I'd rather take the +1 damage, honestly. Enhanced beam optics. So that's going to be my standard. What else we've got? Assault is already equipped. Is this what I want you to have? Extra ammo is probably decent. You've got panic and mind ray, probably not going to help out much, Panda. Although it's possible we'll find some aliens mixed in with the Exalt, seeing as we've been finding Exalt mixed in with the aliens. Also, you have the wrong weapon, so let's make sure you've got the blaster. And we've got a couple little laser pistols. There's no pulse pistols, in case you're wondering. There's pulse versions of the heater, but it's heavy and it lowers your mobility, so it's not my favorite. That looks like fun. I kind of wish we had tactical rigging for this one, but we don't. We are going to bring a pulse carbine with our recoilless rocket. And I might just bring two rockets. We're probably not going to be moving very much, and the more explosives we have, the better. What is danger zone? I forget. Area of effect is even bigger. That's pretty cool. I never decided which of these three I like the most, but bigger explosions, I'll take it. Our scout, I was kind of leaving the scout for a little bit later. How many weapons do we have? One more carbine. We've got two more rifles. I might not have enough pulse weapons for everybody. Depends on how it goes here. We'll do the sniper. Snipers are easy to load out. Maybe armor. We'll give you our big fancy pulse sniper. Pistol. Scope for aim and crit. And beam optics for extra damage. I wish we had better armor, obviously, but such is life. Gunner is actually already equipped, other than switching up the weapon here. Gatling Pulsar, okay. And Commander. Well, on this mission, I don't really care about the arc thrower as much. I think more grenades, honestly. Chem grenades, you only would get one. So maybe we just max out the alien grenades and I just toss grenades like crazy. I give you the pulse carbine so that you're a little bit more mobile. And you just... four grenades. We're going to have lots of explosives. It's a key plan to victory. The medic, I think we're going to double med kit because this is probably going to be a fairly long mission. And I want to have more than just... Now the arc thrower, maybe I should have brought... three charges on the arc thrower just to repair the mechs, just to give us some extra heals. I will give the Aegis armor to the medic. I feel like it's most important to keep that person alive with the double med kit. Yeah, I don't know. Do I want four grenades or two grenades and three heals? Three mech heals. That's a tough one. I figured I was just waiting to see if I'd have enough pulse rifles for everybody here. It turns out I did build enough, which is maybe amazing. Scouts, I will give up a little bit of extra armor so that you can take a hit if lightning reflexes fails us. And after that, I'll just give you a little bit more accuracy, pump you up over 100. Maybe damage is better because scouts can flank easier, but I'm okay with this. Laser pistol, laser pistol. Who else would use a laser pistol if I could split one off? I've got three laser pistols, right? I think I have changed my mind. The Rocketeer is focused all on rockets. We'll let the engineer have the chance to heal, and you can have the laser pistol because I feel generous. And actually, the laser pistol probably works better on someone with enhanced beam optics, but meh. Anyway, let's get our mechs prepped up. I think this is our first mission with double defenders, so that's pretty fun. We got flamethrowers and... one restorative mist. How do I want to do this? You got 18 mobility. The Jaeger will also have 18 mobility, so that's pretty even. Also have a rail gun. You'll also have a flamethrower. They both have a flamethrower. I don't really think restorative mist is that great without the three uses thing. Just one use per mission is pretty weak. I mean, it would heal, what is it, 5 per person? So it could do some really good AoE healing. I'm just trying to decide whether or not I want to bring... we're just going to go with aim, just pump up our aim on our mechs. Trying to decide if I want to bring a grenade and a kinetic strike or a grenade and a mist. And I think I'm going to do the grenade and the mist, to be honest. Let's see, Jaeger perks, holding still, more damage. I don't know, like... I think vital point targeting will only apply to the railgun, not these kind of things. And same with Ranger. Honestly, I don't think it's going to make much difference. We'll give the Jaeger the grenade launcher. And we'll give the Shogun the restorative mist. My reasoning here is the Shogun gets collateral damage, which is a super long range blow up some cover. This way, the Jaeger can also shoot grenades and maybe blow up cover. Although, without Sapper, it's pretty bad at blowing up cover, the way I remember it. Anyway, I think that's about the best team we can make. Hopefully, you guys are all happy with my choices. We're pretty low on flashbangs and smoke and stuff, but It's going to be a long battle, so just one turn of smoke is not going to really change it around too much. I will be putting a save down at the beginning of this mission. I have done it once before, so it's not totally blind on my side campaign. But we'll see how it goes, basically. I'm not super familiar with this map compared to some of the ones we do over and over again. Resistance. Thanks, Central. Okay, I guess it's taking a while to load. It's such a big map. Alright. So, we'll even watch the intro cutscene. Why not? This is a special mission. Double mechs. Looks awesome.
Our objective for this operation is simple. Eliminate
Don't get killed.
Forces within the building and wipe out this threat once
so, it's a pretty big building. On my last mission, they almost all ran out to the front. So I just set a position out here, and they all sort of came out. Almost all of them. I didn't have to really go in the building much. It's pretty cool, though, assuming we don't explode at all. So, yeah, first and foremost, let's make sure we put a save down. Just in case I do something totally stupid and throw the mission. I will plan on playing smartly and not needing it, but you never know. Sometimes the RNG is just horrible. Okay, so we got full cover, pretty solid. Full cover, couple half cover, full cover, but I don't want to move that far forward yet. We got two mechs, eight soldiers. The sniper could probably hang out back here or even back there. I'll want like the infantry somewhere up there, the assault somewhere close by. You know the general rule. So I think first move, let's put Sandless right up here. We might see some, we might not, I don't know. Let's see how it goes.
Target acquired.
Oh, there's one, a sectoid commander over that way.
They're trying to flank us.
Well, I don't think he's going to have a good day. 19 damage in one hit. Oh, Sandless. So, you know, we could go capture that guy if I was quick. I wonder if there's any more out here that... Killifron, you go double check what's up there on the helipad. I don't think I had any out on the outer edges last time. Maybe I forgot. 71, not the best, but you got it anyway. Overkill! That must have been overkill, right? How much damage? I can't even see. Come on, game. You gotta show me how much damage I do. I wanna see. Anyway, that was fine. Mark Spector. I don't really want to pop any more aliens. So we'll keep you probably out of range. Close enough for a flamethrower. And for now, we'll launch. Kittens. We want to keep our medic a little bit back. We want to keep our Buzz Bunny somewhere that can shoot a good rocket. Who's the Boss can do double shots, so you can stay up front. Actually, I don't need Who's the Boss up close because he gets +5 range thanks to that, but it'll work out just fine. Our Scout, I'll put on the left flank for now.
Overwatch, aye, aye.
Kittens, I will keep you sort of... You're only half cover, but you're a little bit further back than the rest of the team. The Sniper, for now, we'll put here. I think this spot might be better. I don't know how easy it is to shoot over top of the helipad. Actually, probably from this spot you can move left or right and shoot. Well, this thing would still block your line. Line of sight is still a sticking point. Let's put our rockets here. I'm expecting to need some rockets very soon, so we'll steady. That leaves us our assaults, who will be put here. Yeah.
Position confirmed.
You generally want the assault near the front.
Moving to Overwatch.
And finally, Commander, looks like you have the mobility to get to some cover.
Roger that.
Alright, let's see how this goes. I feel like our first turn was pretty well positioned. Mechs are in decent spots to burn stuff if we need them. Got a rocket ready, grenades ready. There's going to be a lot of aliens on this map. You can count on it. Or a lot of enemies, that is to say. I don't know how many aliens there'll be. So nothing moved. I think, honestly, the smartest choice here is to just wait for them. We'll move my sniper to where I was originally thinking might be a better spot. And we'll move the mech a bit closer just for more useful flamethrowers. We could move people up to there. I don't think the Exalt will come around the outside of the building. I think they'll be coming through this sort of lobby. I don't know, but that's my suspicion. We can pull you back, Commander, if this doesn't work. Eh, totally worked, no problem. Alright, so now I want the mechs... I guess on cover is fine. I could put someone up there, too.
Moving out.
But it's on higher ground. I don't know if we get, like, plus one aim for being a foot off the ground or not. We do have collateral damage. I might start using collateral damage to blow holes in the wall so I can see rather than move forward much more, to be honest. Let's move...
Out of there now.
Flaming pen. I mean, and I'm still kind of worried about,
Roger. Got my eyes on.
You know, rocket or heavy exalts that throw rock, shoot rockets, and other exalts that shoot, that throw grenades. So really, we want them to come to us, and we want to stay split up a little bit just in case bad things happen. Okay, well, there's something over there. We're pretty well positioned to deal with it. I have to assume that somebody will come to check us out. You can kind of hear them. There they are. See? You know, I knew they were going to come. Sanlis takes a shot. Hits the sniper, or what do they call them? Sniper exalt, whatever you want to call them. And Spectre murderifies. Well, taking out one and blowing up a wall, that gives us better line of sight. So I may use a rocket or a grenade here to destroy their cover. We've got lots of rockets. We've only got two grenades. We do have collateral damage, which I believe always destroys cover. And that might be the best way to guarantee some nice easy kills. Plus, it might take up ammo, but it's not consumable. It's not like, you know, we've got a limited number of rockets. We can use this as many times as we want, the way I understand it. And even though the radius isn't huge, I have a feeling this will completely destroy that wall, so long as it's... The way I've been read it, and been explained, so long as whatever object is within that sphere of destruction, it will completely destroy that entire object. So that whole wall, this whole wall, basically, other than the pipe to the roof. Plus, it will do a little bit of damage to these guys. If I center it right on them. A little bit of damage. I think this is the smart move here. We should have lots of shots to kill these guys off. Assuming what it happened. Yeah, I think they're flanked now, right? Assuming we can get line of sight. Yeah, they're just standing out in the open. 100% chance. Kill a Fron. I like it. You didn't quite kill him, but 10 damage. Can't complain. Should see if the sniper has a shot too before I get too crazy here. Another 100% on the other guy. Might as well take it. Alright. Congratulations, you got a promotion. I feel like this was well handled. Now, there's still going to be one left that's not 85% miss. Boo. There you go, 100%. There's still one more that we haven't dealt with, right? I'm pretty sure that was a pod of four. We Overwatch killed one, and then we shot two dead. Sanlis unfortunately did not get the lock and load, so I can't reload and Overwatch on the same turn. I think we just Overwatch the rest of the team. And hopefully we've got enough saved up that if he comes out, we just murderize him. Or another pod activates. Yeah, this is why I didn't want to go in the building. Or doesn't activate, interestingly enough. Alright, come on, let's kill him. Commander, that may have doomed us all by opening up that wall. We now may see the other one. Well, maybe there was more than just one left over. It was a good hit, though. Can't argue with that. I really like our current position, so I'm not really planning on moving in there very quickly. Can you take a shot or anything, buddy? Alright, a Muton Elite! How did he activate? So those guys we can see. That's all the HP on that guy. That's sick! Alright, and the Elite kind of hides out. We might, Oh, I can't collateral damage every turn. I was thinking destroy that wall. Well, we want to make sure that guy dies. That's for sure. Only one person can see him? Two people. Alright, yeah. Sniper, 56%, huh? Who's the boss? Can get two shots if he needs it. We take two shots here. He will be getting the executioner bonus, right? Because he's halfway dead. Sure, two shots at 62, pretty good chance. We only needed the one. So that wastes our double tap, unfortunately. Next turn, we'll only get one shot. Now, we're at the point where there's a lot of activated exalts, and it'd be much better to start taking them down, but I think we're just going to keep overwatching, unless we can sneak, like, an amazing rocket. Oh, man, look at the area of effect on the Shredder. Oh, that's... We're going to have some great rockets today. I'm surprised we can't actually sneak a rocket quite where I wanted. I can get up to the doorway. That would destroy probably most of the wall. But I think we steady weapon and then keep the rest on Overwatch. Yeah. We'll at least be able to kill the first one or two that comes out. There's an elite. And this guy. Oh, lightning reflexes. My butt. Someone get lucky. Wow, he's got no cover up there anyway. Stupid perks. Oh man, one guy is gonna ruin all of our reflex, all of our overwatches. Garbage. Thanks, Long War devs, for adding bull. One guy takes out every single overwatch shot. It's as bad as the chrysalids. I mean, he's got, what, 10, 20, 26 HP, I think? It's going to be tough to take him down, but the fact that he's going to dodge every single shot is garbage. Oh, we got one, finally! If it wasn't for lightning reflexes, he'd be totally dead. And he still got cover out anyway, after we blew up everything. Alright, what are you guys going to do back there? There's not much cover up front if you want to come at me. You guys got to be, careful. Are you going to stand out in the open and take a shot? Oh, we still had an overwatch. Two! Alright, well at least we got one hit. We definitely want to kill the elite, because he's got those horrible grenades. But if they're going to stand out in the open, that's good for us. Alright, I'm pretty happy. I'm annoyed by this guy, but you know, it could have been a lot worse, right? 64%, huh? Because there's overwatches, I could pretty easily move Panda up here, shoot him, and then move back because of his in the zone. On the other hand, we can pretty reliably disable this guy. I don't need to worry about him too much, thanks to our Psy Panic. I'm tempted to just destroy that cover there, because I don't want them moving out this way anyway. Oh, we need not enough ammo, yeah. Well, I guess I don't worry about it then right now. 64%. Could flush him. He'll probably move out of full cover into less cover. This will take up all of our railgun's ammo. Or we can just take a normal shot and still have ammo for next turn. I think because we've got the flamethrower, I don't mind taking this shot. Move this guy somewhere easier. He actually hit him. Well, 94%. That was a flush, right? What? He didn't move. I'm sure I clicked flush, right? Double check, but I'm pretty sure that was supposed to be a flush shot. Yeah, we're out of ammo. That was flush, and he didn't move. I don't understand it. Is flush bugged? Is that the problem? We'll take the 81% here, I guess. If we miss this guy a couple times like that, I may just panic him. We can't see with the here from there. The medic's got a low chance. Jackie's got a better chance. Sandless has one shot, really. I think we go for this guy first, and then we reload. Alright, good. That guy's dead. That was important. Reload. What else do we got? Gatling Pulsar. Yeah, might as well take this shot. Alright, this elite is doing really good at standing in the middle of nowhere. Oh, we still got double tap. See, I didn't know how it worked. I thought I had seen before where I've seen it activate like it did last turn. And then you didn't use it, but then next turn it didn't activate. This time, we shot once, it seemed to activate, but then the next turn we managed to use it anyway. So, I mean, that's better. I'm happier that that mechanic works correctly. That's the way it should work. 67%. Maybe we should have shot this one first because of the high damage if we'd hit, and the holo targeting. Having a hard time hitting this guy. Well, Jackie's up to 93. There you go. Pulse weapons, you know, they're pretty high damage. Alright. Now, I could consider shooting a rocket in there now. Because we steady weaponed, it'd be a pretty good shot. But I think, you know, I'm willing to let them keep coming to us. We'll Overwatch this time. We're a little bit lower on Overwatch numbers.
Roger that. Scanning.
Just Overwatch. I don't want to take that long shot right now. Let's make them come to us. I mean, they may shoot us from way back there. It's possible, but most of the guys up front are in full cover or a mech. And you can actually see, I feel pretty proud about my mech positions. My mechs are behind the front line, so the aliens have to see these three guys, they have to see these two in full cover and move closer than that to have a shot on the mech or the half covers. I think that was well set up. None of them decided to come out and play. I think we used this turn to reload a couple people, like the mech.
Back online.
Killifron can reload. If you're down to like one ammo, maybe we reload, or if you're out of ammo, obviously. And then I try to leave enough overwatches so that if they run out, we'll still have a pretty good shot. Pretty good chance of killing them, at least. That's my line. I don't want everybody reloading, because then somebody can run out and, just run up close and shoot me. Come on, Exalt. Come into the death zone. I know there's lots of you guys activated. I'll blow this wall up if I have to. Alright, this guy decides to come out. We blow up some more of the wall. The more we blow up, the less cover they get, and the less... the better line of sight we get, actually. Well, that worked. This wall. Well, the Exalt HQ. Unfortunately, we activated another pod by shooting that wall open, but it's okay, right? Alright, I think it's time for a rocket. There's quite a few in there. We're gonna use a normal rocket. I hope I can shoot it somewhere I want to shoot it. What I did there was I just aimed up a little bit, and now I can shoot it pretty much wherever I want. Although it is, like, one tile above ground. Maybe not quite anywhere. Yeah, I think I would like to blow up more of this back wall and a little bit of that wall if possible, so I think this is our shot. This guy's hunkered down. If I can destroy his little cover, we'll be able to take him out. I forgot to steady weapon with my Rocketeer here, so we could have had a perfect shot, like no scatter at all, but it still looked like that was a pretty good shot. That went basically where I wanted it, I think. Alright, so what do we got? This guy's out. That guy's out. We gotta kill five kills. This shouldn't be too bad, right? Start with this guy. This is the kind of ambush I dream about. I'm so happy, guys. I can't believe this is working. Double tap. We're getting all kinds of good stuff here. Alright, we take the 97. This is also a squad sight shot, technically, out of range of the normal Gatling gun, or a normal weapon. So the people on this side are kind of out of range now, which is probably fine. Sandless can only see two of them, so I think we focus down the more dangerous one here, because he's got a lot of HP. I might have been smarter to use the mech shot on this guy, but... Aw, Sandless, come on, buddy. 94%, right? We are... We could use some flamethrower, but I don't want to move close enough to really risk that. Could shoot a grenade in there. 60%. Actually, not as good of a shot as I would have expected. Let's try to finish this guy off with Commander. There you go. We just got to kill enough of these guys that they can't cause too much trouble. 48%. 1%. I wonder if the laser pistol would do enough damage for this to be worthwhile. Not really. You know what? I think the smart thing to do with Flaming Panda is move full cover, shoot, and then move back. No, that's not close enough. We'd have to move into the zone here. There may be some overwatches back there. This isn't super safe. We'll take this shot with Killifron. 80% is... That's a bad miss. I really need to kill that guy. Doesn't he have a rocket launcher? So we're going to move a couple step closer with Mark Spector. We really need to kill that guy. 76%. Come on, buddy. There we go. Anybody with a rocket launcher is extra threatening. Maybe before I move, before I try the dangerous move of Flaming Panda. There is an Overwatch over there, yeah, so there is at least one. Maybe what I try is to move Jackie up to here, or even up to here. I don't want to get too close, really. I mean, even here is pretty solid. I don't know if you'd have a shot from here. Pretty safe at the moment. And you'd have a, if you're in range, I don't know for sure, but let's try it. Let's give it a shot. Yes, you're in range. Woohoo! 83% is pretty solid. Could have taken the flush, but I felt confident in my luck. Nailed it. I think I'm okay with that number of kills. There's still going to be a fair number left, but this might be a decent turn to pop our smoke. But I don't think I need to. So we just move Kittens a little bit closer and put on Overwatch. Oh, I forgot about the sniper completely. We could have killed that guy with a sniper. And yeah, we're not shooting that far. I expect they're going to keep running into us, but we'll see. I mean, we killed a lot of dudes. That's got to count for something. All right, taking the first shot. And he totally misses and blows up his own wall. We're going to have to move our scout out of there. We get at least one reaction shot. Alright, Kittens misses. Medics, you know, aren't the best at shooting, but it's okay. He's got... Is that half cover or full cover? I don't even know. Alright, 2 damage on our mech. Clap, clap. That's the best you can do, huh? So, I am noticing that this wall is on fire, so it could burn down at the end of the turn, and then Jackie would be in a bad position. Does this count as full cover or half cover? Half cover, okay, I think. No, actually full cover for that guy. He's right behind some little doodad in the middle. It's probably non-destructible too, which is more of a pain. Sniper, 36, 46, not great. Commander needs to reload. Maybe I should have thrown a grenade. I should have checked. Hmm. 32, 42 on this guy that's way back there. Sandless, 49, 59. I think we go for this guy first. Oh, good. Covering fire, of course. Well, look at that damage absorption. Good work, Sandless. You soaked that up well. And you killed him in one shot.
I need ammo. Dead and gone.
I'm okay with 3 damage. Alright, so that was covering fire. I could have checked, but I didn't. We're going to need to reload our big old Gatling laser here pretty soon. Do we get double tap this turn? I can't even remember. I haven't been keeping good track. Let's find out. No double tap. Maybe should have reloaded or instead. Well, 21, 31. We're not having any great shots right now. Yeah, that's not going to happen. I'm always surprised at how not far we can throw grenades from a grenade launcher on a mech. It feels like we can shoot further than we can launch a grenade. Maybe that's true. Maybe that's fair. I don't know. 36. Okay, well, let's just try to get holo targeting on it at least. So it's a bad shot. Or wait. We got flush. Killifron just can't see him. We're just going to need to move a little bit closer with Killifron.
Position confirmed.
And then I think... Maybe? The wrong one. Dang. Well, we'll flush that one. Why not? That one at least moved, and we did manage to hit it. Not the most effective. Now we don't know where it is. I'm kind of surprised that we can see this guy from here, but not from there. I don't know. Some sort of weird full cover mechanic for the center. I mean, even the sniper can see him from whatever angle that is. Ah, we steady weapon, actually. 36, steady weapon. And you can just overwatch in case something is risky and comes out.
I'm on it, Commander.
Oh, you know, we could have... It's too late now, but we could have, I forgot that our scout had flush. Yeah, we could use Jackie to flush this guy. Yeah, that would have been a better final shot there. We'll go on Overwatch. We'll do Overwatch as well. And you can reload. That wasn't the best turn ever, but I think the previous turns put me in a good enough position that we're okay. We may take a shot. Oh, he just Overwatches. Look at that. The exact spot that our scout was standing burned down. It's like I'm a genius sometimes. Oh, don't say that. I'm about to mess something up for sure. Okay. We're going to flush this guy out of there. He's on Overwatch, of course, but we got lightning reflexes to counter that. So I still think that was the best option. I'd mostly forgotten about the covering fire. My bad. Instead, he just moves out in the middle of nowhere, and we should be able to just crush him. Good hit, plus holo targeting. Pretty happy with that. We'll let the other mech maybe finish him off. Alright. So, I think there's still at least one activated, but none of them are up close. Do we steady or do we... Oh, probably just steady with a sniper. You're overwatching. Actually, steadying would have been better for... That was my bad. Should have steadied with the rockets. Overwatch. I might heal up Sanlis. I could pop the restorative mist now and heal both of those guys to max. Okay, we're not going to move yet. Make sure everyone's reloaded. Yeah, see, I thought I still had one or two left. Reload. Probably both the mechs need to reload, actually.
Roger that.
Pretty much.
Good to go.
Why move in when you're not at max, right? Come on, Exalt. Are you scared? Okay, we know there's some guys in there.
Shh. You hear that?
Come on out! Come out and play. Don't make me come in there. There could easily be still like 20 left. I don't know. I haven't been counting how many we killed. We've killed a lot, but... So what we do, now that there's no more walls on fire... I mean, we could put someone on the roof to shoot down. I haven't done that before ever. But I don't think that's my... I don't think that's the move. I think the move is have a look from this vantage point and see what we can see. Yeah, okay, you found one. And you've managed to flank him. And it's a sniper that has no covering fire, so probably going to kill him. Alright. It's like I knew where he would be before we saw him. Ah, it was just a sound ping. I know there's still one more on the right side. So, let's just hold off. Is he gonna come at us? Or do we have to come at him? There he is. Rocketeer. Oh no, there's a bunch of them. It's more than one. I figured there'd be more than one, honestly. Awesome! 29 damage. That guy got smoked. Is this another pod, maybe? I don't know, couldn't tell. Do we blow up their cover again? He's standing behind some fancy statue. Who's got a shot? Sniper, no. Mech, yes. Mech, yes. Engineer, no. So we got two mech shots. With not the greatest. He's only got 10 HP, but he's got a rocket launcher, right? So we want to make sure he dies. Haven't needed to use any of my... I've only used one rocket so far. It's kind of amazing. How far can you throw, Commander? You know, I think this is a reasonable use for our one of our alien grenades here. It should blow up his cover. We've got Sapper. It's an engineer. You know, it usually works. Think it blew up his cover? Yeah. All right. That should make it pretty easy to peg this guy off. Mark Spector, 86. And looks like you got it. No Rocketeers allowed to get close. We also could have used collateral damage. I suppose maybe that would have been a bit better on the consumables. But I think we're fine.
Covering now.
I'm not going to complain too much about possibly wasting one grenade. Alright, now what? The enemy turns are getting shorter and shorter. I think it may be time to start moving forward. Let's move Commander up to this wall, see what he can see. Can't see anything. Alright, well, we're not going to move forward quickly. Don't get me wrong.
Position confirmed.
Seeing as we've destroyed most of the cover, it would be a bad idea to dash in there, I think. We'll put one mech on each side of this
It looks like Exalt prefers form over function. Not what I'd call a winning strategy.
Okay, we'll move Sandless up to here.
Roger, I've got my eyes on
Overwatch is probably the name of the game. I think actually I'm gonna actually heal Sandless up to max, just so he doesn't get an unlucky crit kill that takes him out or something wonky. Cause you never know, right? You never know. Can we move? Can we jump over these grates? I don't think so. We'll just put Panda here. I want to move up to that wall next.
Roger. Got my eyes on.
And you know, this seems like a reasonable spot for at least one person, right? Hunker down. They'll never have a chance to shoot you, unless they have grenades, which they probably do. We'll move our sniper a bit closer. Still pretty good vantage point, I feel, and our rockets.
Yes, ma'am.
A little bit closer, steady weapon, and then the rest. I don't know how many are left. But we've killed a sectoid commander, a muton elite. I don't know how many pods we've activated. 3? Maybe 4? It's been hard to tell because sometimes it's been just on the edge of my vision. We know there's one steadying his weapon right there at the bottom of the staircase. He's scared. If he was the only one, we could probably just move a mech up and shoot him in the face. But we don't know if he's the only one, so probably a bad idea. So we'll move our people up carefully.
Yes, Commander.
Oh, I was going to heal you first. I'm sorry about that. That was the wrong move by a little bit.
I'm on my way.
Okay, well, we finally entered their fancy building. Took me a long time to build up the nerve to get in here. But I think it was handled pretty well. I don't know about you guys. This is feeling like our first alien base assault so far. Oh, wait, hold on. Before you move there... For whatever reason, this direction is not actually cover. So that's a bad move. I wanna be able to medicate. Dash kitten's over, we'll do a paramedic heal next time. I just wanna have, you know, max HP before I do something silly, basically. And besides, that exalt could come up the stairs any time. You never know. You're pretty quick.
Okay.
Move up here. Just a little bit closer. Oh, you can jump over those too, by the way. Easier to run and gun if required. Maybe reload some people next turn, just so we're maxed out on ammo. I mean, if this is the last guy, then I'm, you know, overdoing it. But I don't know if it's the last guy or not, so... I really want to play it safe. I feel like it's been played really well so far. I don't think I've made any really big mistakes, and I don't want to change that. Oh, you heard me healing. That's cool.
Sound
I don't
want to
mess
detected.
It up now.
Yes,
come on back. I don't care if the mech's taking 2 damage. I don't think that's going to affect much. We could also throw a grenade down on him. I don't know for sure if that would hit him, though.
Moving
move forward
on.
Just a few squares.
I'm impressed. They even managed to
the evil hologlobe. I'm sure someone's telling me, that's the last Exalt, don't worry, Blue, you're fine. But worrying is what keeps us alive. Alright, and you know, it's starting to feel like this is the last guy. Next turn, I may be willing to, move a mech down there and just blast him smithereens. Let's move up here. It's half cover, but... I think at this point we're relatively secure. This is actually full cover, so that's good.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
And you can just move up a little bit.
Head to that location. Affirmative, covering now.
Gatling laser. I don't know for sure. We'll stay strong in the middle mostly. And we'll let Jackie just reload, I guess. I figure we would have heard a sound ping from that side by now if there was something coming. I think it's safe to say that whatever's left is either leftovers from a pod or a stationary pod. I don't think there's going to be any patrols left at this point. So, at this point, let's move the mech to the top of the stairs and see what you can see. Killifron can't see anything. I guess it's hiding? The battle music came back, but we can't actually see it. Let's have Spectre move to the top of this staircase instead.
With you guys.
Okay. Maybe there really is just one left. Well, I'm willing to dash up. Oh, there it is! What a good hiding spot. I never would have seen you there. Can I, I can't use the flamethrower. What do I have? Who can... Well, I know one person that knows how to deal with that. That's actually a relatively safe spot too. Run and gun! Panda!
Double time.
Take him out, please. This should be a pretty high percent of 13 damage. From this close... I mean, maybe it doesn't crit. Come on, Panda. Yeah, take him. Is that it? No. Alright, Panda's in pretty well good cover, I think. So, feels like this side is unlikely to have anything left. I've never been back there. There's probably, like, one left hiding over there, or maybe there's another pod, I don't know. I think we don't want to activate it right now, though, wherever it is. Let's put our Gatling Pulsar a little bit closer on a pretty good spawn, I feel. And the scout can just hold that flank. Mech can hold that flank. We'll move Kittens considerably closer. Seeing as there's not going to be much back here, and probably the same with the sniper, to be honest. I don't want to be rash, but I think we're basically done this mission. Maybe this is easier than... alien base assault. Or I just really had good positioning, maybe. Is that the key? Well, this counts as full cover, Commander, and then you can see this angle, which is pretty safe. I was thinking for a final move, that was kind of... Oh, look! One last pod. Alright. We get an overwatch. Misses. I think we're in a good position to deal with this, though. Was there four or five of them?
No contact with
probably five. Alright, we're not doing very good on hitting Overwatch. That's okay.
Missed the target.
This is probably the last one. There they go. They're all hiding up there. Well, I sure hope we can get a rocket in there. Alright, good job. At least we got one Overwatch out of three. Another one with a ton of HP, though. It's probably got lightning reflexes again. Now, unfortunately, I did not put the Rocketeer in a terribly effective position for this one. We'll get two Gatling Pulsars. Maybe we just run up and flamethrower them, to be honest. I haven't even used my flamethrower. They're all in, like, half cover. It's just a matter of if the flamethrower has range. Which I think is the most fun thing to do. Let's try. Come on!
We seem to have acquired a vast array of technology on par with our own.
Well, it'll only hit two, but I think that's still worth it. It'll kill one for sure, and should panic the other one.
Yep. Losing control of the situation.
You're definitely losing control of the situation. Alright, I think that was a good option. What do we have here? We can use no... We've got no run-in gun, although we could pretty safely take this guy out with the assault and still move back into cover. And then I don't have to worry about this guy with anybody else. This should be, like, guaranteed. I know our mech is a little bit exposed, but there's only two shots left, assuming we can't deal with them. This counts as better cover from the angle you'll be shot at, if you're shot at. Who's the boss? Gets two shots. 57. I mean, it would be... Oh, the sniper's got shots, too. I'd like to try to destroy their cover first. Maybe instead of the flamethrower, I should have tried the grenade launcher. Oh, collateral damage. We got it. I forgot. I always forget. Collateral damage. Yeah, that'll deal with it. I think you guys are about to have a bad day. Collateral damage is pretty awesome. Sandus can only see one, so we'll let him shoot that guy. And then we should be able to wrap this up pretty smoothly.
Out of the game.
Yeah, sorry, Sandus. You only get
got
one.
It covered.
Maybe the sniper could kill one? Let's focus on the really high HP guy, because he'll take the most shots. And he's the most dangerous, so if we could kill him, that would be the best. For the best. You know, it's not guaranteed that we'll be able to kill him either. So keep that in mind. But we should get two pretty good shots here. I could potentially suppress, but I feel the odds are in our favor for a kill. 97%. It must have gone past the executioner phase. And then who's the boss? Execute! I love those Gatling pulsers. So good. So much damage. I don't even know. We did at least 13 on the first hit. What else do we do? Anyone else have a shot? Kittens can move and shoot if there's any room for you. I mean, with only one guy left standing in the open, is there any chance, like, could we just stand out in the open and kill him? We've got like three shots, maybe even four shots, depending on if I can see him from here. You can't see him from there, that's too bad. We might not be able to kill the last one. You wouldn't have been able to make it there anyway. You can make it to this side. Get one shot here from Kittens. I was gonna say, if we didn't have line of sight, I would have been kind of annoyed. It's a good solid hit. It does give him plus 10 aim. I don't think we'll be able to get a shot out of Buzz Bunny. Doesn't look like it.
When you love us.
Unless I use like a crazy rocket. I mean, it would have been nice to get a rocket back there. I could have. I still could. I could hit him with a shredder rocket if I really wanted, I guess. That might have been enough to finish him off in this turn. On the other hand, it might hit one of my guys. Ah! You only live once. Oh, it's gonna... I don't even know what that was... Oh, right, our mech. Yeah. I forgot. If I shot the rocket first, I should have checked out the rocket. I mean, we collateral damaged it just fine. Let's not worry about it. Commander, you're the last one. I think I take the chance that you kill him and put you in half cover.
Moving to position.
Seeing as you have a... you should have a shot. It's pretty good. You might get the kill. If not, it's okay. It's pretty darn close. That gives him one counter shot, but I think that was still worth the chance to finish him off. He does just run away anyway. That's what usually happens when there's only one left. They sort of run for it. Unfortunately for him, you know, mechs are pretty quick. Alright, and he has no cover. Killifron, you know what to do, right? Okay, guys. I think that's the end of the Exalt. Yep. Woohoo! No reloading, no trouble.
Our local affiliates
at barely got scratched, honestly.
That a minor electrical fire was reported.
Yeah, minor electrical fire.
Of a large office building downtown.
Oh, it makes me feel so good, guys. After that last Exalt mission where we... I struggled. I don't know about you guys, but I struggled. This one felt real good.
It's certainly reassuring to know that our
no hacking relays, just murder.
Still putting their lives at risk to deal with these situations.
Good job, XCOM. I salute you.
I'll give Exalt some credit. They managed to hide their primary.
Sure they did. Now they're done. Ha ha! Happy Christmas, everybody. It's a little bit of a late Christmas present.
Our troops are making it easy out there.
Very good. Very good.
Don't get too cocky.
Yeah, don't get too cocky. That's true. But on the other hand, good work. All right, Kittens. Gunnery Sergeant Medic. Sprinter is pretty awesome. Ready for Anything's not bad. If I was smart and gave you Opportunist instead of Revive, because I think Opportunist is better than Revive, then I think I would take Ready for Anything on Gunnery Sergeant. And the aim and the... the willpower is also solid for a psionic. But Sprinter is really good. I just can't turn off Sprinter. Sprinter is too solid. Can't turn it down. Alright, Sniper! We've got a Gunnery Sergeant. So what do we want? Probably Vital Point Targeting. Plus 2 damage is a double Ranger. And crits are good, but when you're using Squad Sight, remember how Squad Sight works? Minus 30% crit chance, which is how you're supposed to use your snipers. So it's less likely you'll be getting crits compared to an assault, for instance. And then disabling assault shot is also very good. Don't deny it. I just want to see if it gives you any stats. No stats. I think I like damage. I get you Gunslinger. Tactical sense. Damn good ground. Yeah, I think I just give you the guaranteed 2 damage against almost every single alien we fight against, except, like, drones, which we don't care about too much, right? Drones don't get autopsied. Pretty much everything else does. Even the mechanicals. So I think that's pretty awesome. I think that's what we go for. Maybe you could argue disabling shots better, possibly, but I like killing stuff more than disabling it. Engineer! Okay, now this is a pretty obvious one again. If you've been working on Overwatches, like Rapid Reaction instead of Grenades, I guess that's it, then Ready for Anything might be better because you get 2 shots out of that. Wheel to Survive is pretty good, but Packmaster gives you an extra grenade and an extra Arc Thrower charge, which is pretty good in my books, so that's what I pick. And finally, Killifron, you got yourself a promotion too, good work. Jaegers, I think Executioner. Damage control, I'm not really sold on. Lone Wolf, I don't think it's going to be too often we're going to split up enough that that's going to take effect with something like a Jaeger. Executioner is not the best ability, but I think it's better than the other two. Tech Sergeant just isn't a great level for Jaegers. I think it's the next two. Gunnery and Master. I think one of them will give you Squad Sight, which is not bad, and one of them will give you Light 'em Up, which is maybe the best ability in the game. So Executioner, for now, that'll just have to do. Alright, that was the kind of mission we needed. We got some art, some artifacts, some tech. I think we just sell it. Got weapon fragments. We didn't capture anything. It's fine.
Headquarters destroyed. And the
destroyed.
Remaining is in hiding.
We shouldn't have oh, so good. I'm so happy about section. That, actually. That mission went way better than I was expecting.
Aliens themselves.
Really, really solid. So let's look at our presents. Oh, look, I had some spare shot down stuff I forgot about. So forget about that. Let's see. Wait a second. I had alien food as well. I'm not paying very good attention to my supplies, am I? Did we get that from Exalt, or did we get that from, like, a ship? We don't need that for nothing. Okay, I just want to see how much we got from the HQ. I had 240 bucks that I hadn't even noticed. Alright, we picked up specifically $300, $700, and $200. $900 altogether. Maybe people request these, I don't care. $900! We're rich! Yeehaw! We can do stuff. We're pretty short on Meld and Illyrium. We got a little bit. Let's see. I think this is the time for tactical rigging. We don't need weapon fragments too badly. 300 bucks. This is if we can ever afford it. Now we can afford it. Close combat is just not that big of a deal. Most of these things still take Meld. Do we start this up? I really wish I knew what this did better. Doubles the chance of our interceptors detecting absent satellite coverage. That doesn't matter for the way I play. In addition, detects suborbital UFOs anywhere in the world regardless of satellite or interceptor cover. I don't know. It's not cheap and I kind of need the Illyrium. Illyrium's not just going to grow on
the
trees.
Boys down in the foundry busy. I'll let them know you've got another project
ready
for
production. I think we queue up another Illyrium generator. Oh man, we could do an Illyrium generator and a satellite nexus right now. That would give us... We don't even need a Nexus. We need an uplink. Two more satellites, and then we can cover the world in satellites. I'll need to destroy another fission generator to build the hyperwave relay. Yeah, I think... Honestly, let's queue some stuff up. This will be the final uplink we need, even though we won't get... Sorry, I need a Nexus, right? I need two. That'll be South America. 10 Illyrium. Do I have enough Illyrium to do all this? No, I can only do one or the other right now. We're going to start the Illyrium generator right now. That'll be the last generator we need. I figured it's really slow. We'll start a Nexus soon. And then we can destroy the two fission generators and build the hyperwave relay and the Gallup chamber. And we should be set. That's the end game. And... That's it for those. We spent all our Illyrium. Let's build two more satellites just in case they get shot down by Fluke. It can happen. All the other things I would build is probably more... I mean, I could buy some more aircraft. Oh man, I should split these guys up a little bit better here. We've got too many in Africa. I mean, we're going to take back North America pretty soon. And... Maybe I'll want some more interceptors and laser cannons for that. Oh yeah, right. Phoenix coal gun. I forgot about that. Build me one more laser cannon. It's not that expensive. And maybe at the end of the month, I might queue up a couple more laser cannons and a couple more ships. Just for North America, because that is the plan. As soon as we get... How long away is that, by the way? Just double check here. 19 days, so middle of January we'll want to have more. Maybe I'll just save my money till then anyway. We'll see what the end of the month brings us.
Aircraft transfer incomplete.
And it's an A. Oh yeah. I think we did good, guys. I think the campaign is not in the bag, but I think we're on the right track. We still got some pretty panicky nations. And depending on how the terror missions go, we can certainly
we'll be watching.
We can certainly still lose a country here and there, like Nigeria, and the UK is actually really low on their shield defense. But I'm pretty happy with how this has gone. I think I'm going to end my episode here with a big huzzah, and next episode, we'll try out January. We've still not seen any sectopods, which is promising. I don't expect it's going to take very long, but I think we're equipped pretty much enough to deal with them. Plasma would be better. But I think it's time to just start blasting through the research.
Your efforts to support the
and
research
it's going to take a couple more months to finish the research anyway. And we'll start working on the end game stuff. Thanks for watching, folks. Hope you've enjoyed, and have a great day.